Trust your first impression.
What are you seeing or feeling? What impressions do you have? Look around you. Use that inner vision.
Use your feeling, your knowing. Are you indoors or outdoors? How does it feel? Use your senses. What are you experiencing? The only way I know where you are is if you tell me. Where are you?
It feels like space.
Feels like space. Very good. So tell me what's out in space. Look around you. The more you speak, the more I'll be able to help you. And the more you speak, the more you'll see. Describe everything around you. Colors, beautiful. What colors do you see?
Violet.
Mm-hmm. Any other colors? Look around you. What do you see?
I see Earth.
I see Earth. Beautiful. Tell me more.
I see colors around it.
Mm-hmm. What colors do you see around Earth?
Bands of colors.
Mm-hmm. What do you imagine these bands are for?
Energy.
Mm-hmm. So now that you see these colors, I want you to use your mind telepathically to decipher what these bands are. What do you get from these bands and these colors?
It's the energy. It's the aura.
Mm-hmm.
It's subtotal of all of us.
Mm-hmm. The total of all of us. Mm-hmm. And as you look at this aura, what feelings do you get from the aura? What is the aura saying? What's the health of it?
It's changing.
Mm-hmm. It's changing. So tell me how it's changing. Connect with it. It can speak to you.
What's it telling you?
Reaching out.
It's reaching out. Mm-hmm. What
message? Trying to talk.
Mm-hmm. Trying to talk.
I'm looking for someone. There are so many entities.
Mm-hmm. Do these entities have a form?
They're like I am.
Mm-hmm. Do you have a form?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So use a mirror to see yourself and tell me what you look like.
I'm myself.
Mm-hmm.
I'm energy.
Mm-hmm. Energy. Do you have a color?
I'm white light.
White light. Beautiful. So these entities that are around you.
There's endless.
Endless. Mm-hmm. Can you connect with them?
They're
mm-hmm.
on Earth.
No, they're on Earth.
There are thousands.
Mm-hmm.
In the bands of light.
In the bands of light around Earth?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Now, when they're around Earth, do they take on a different color to match the band? Or do they continue to be white?
So many different colors.
Mm-hmm.
All together.
All together. So all of the different colors create the white?
It's like a rainbow of mm-hmm. aura.
Mm-hmm. More colors.
Lower
colors. Mm-hmm. What are these lower colors?
It's like the colors of the rainbow. Mm-hmm. Lower mm-hmm. vibrations. Dimmer colors.
Mm-hmm. Tell me more about this and these entities and yourself. What are you doing there?
We're waiting for something.
You're waiting for something. Mm-hmm. What are you waiting for?
Something that doesn't happen very often.
Mm-hmm. Can you tell me what it's all about?
The evolution.
Evolution?
Of humanity.
Mm-hmm. Now you say it doesn't happen very often. When was the last time that it happened?
A long time ago.
Mm-hmm. What happened then?
A gathering.
Mm-hmm. Tell me more.
Many coming to participate.
Mm-hmm. What are they participating in?
Evolution.
Evolution. Can you describe
to
me?
Mankind.
Can you describe to me what this evolution entails? What does it mean by evolution when we talk about mankind? Is it physical, emotional, mental evolution, spiritual? Can you tell me about the evolution?
It's both.
Mm-hmm.
Man is being forced to evolve, whether he's ready or not.
Mm-hmm. How is this happening?
Pastime.
It's pastime.
Man was meant to evolve sooner.
So why were they held back?
Distractions.
What kind of distractions?
Distractions.
Oh, distractions. I see. What are we being distracted by right now?
Our ego.
Mm-hmm.
Greed.
Now, you had said that we had evolved before, a long time ago. Is that correct?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Well, what happened then?
We started again.
How is it that we start?
We will it.
You will it. Is the planet destroyed when it is evolved?
No.
So how did you will the evolution? What do you use?
Collective thought.
Are these the lights that we see around the planet? The thoughts from these light beings?
Yes.
So tell me.
There are many here.
There are many here, okay. Tell me more about the ones that are on Earth now.
They are us. And we are you.
Can you elaborate on that?
So many are making the choice now to come here and help.
Mm-hmm.
More and more are incarnating to the physical. here.
Mm-hmm. As they incarnate as babies, how long does it take for them to influence the others?
Almost immediate.
How do they do that?
Some, just the act itself of being here is an influence.
Okay. And when we arrive on this earth, what is it that these beings do?
We influence one another. All things.
All things. What is it that you're doing now as a being? Are you influencing the earth?
I know it's difficult each time. It's not home.
It's not home. Where is home?
Another planet.
Where is this planet?
It occupies another space.
Does it occupy the
another
same?
Another dimension.
Another dimension. That's what I was going to ask, if it was in the same dimension as the Earth.
It's difficult to come to Earth.
How do you arrive to Earth? How do you go there?
It's traveling without moving.
Traveling without moving. What do you use to take you there?
Our minds.
Does Earth have a particular vibration or something that you hone in on?
Yes. It's difficult.
Is it some sort of a mathematical destination? Like a point that you know how to get to?
Yes.
Like an address, like a mathematical address. You say it's difficult to explain this. I want you to
we
move.
We can fold time.
Excuse me?
We can fold time.
You can fool time? How do you do that?
We can fool time.
Oh, fool time. Okay.
There is the concept of time. It's an illusion.
Tell me more.
We can use our energy, travel without moving quickly. Mm-hmm. Earth takes much energy to get here.
Why is that?
The space is not the same. The properties of this universe.
The space is not...
It's different.
It's different? Mm-hmm. What's special about the Earth?
It's important.
Mm-hmm.
It's unique.
Mm-hmm. Why do people choose to be born on Earth?
It's considered there are many warriors here. Mm-hmm. In life,
what do you mean by warriors?
It's considered to be a great achievement.
A great achievement.
To learn to be a human of Earth.
So you consider it a great achievement to be a human of Earth. What is it that's so important or difficult to become a human?
The life experience lived here.
What's different about it?
The ego.
The ego.
The emotions. The addictions. It's difficult to escape.
Why was Earth created like this?
Creator experiment in evolution.
The Creator experimented in this evolution?
How far away from the light people survive?
Tell me more. What was this? Go on.
Many are blind here.
Many are blind here?
Yes.
Blind to what?
Their full potential.
Why is that?
They forget where I came from.
And where is that?
The Creator. The One.
Now, when we started out, you were saying that you were going to wait, you're waiting for the evolution of the earth.
It's happening now.
It's happening now.
I can see it.
Tell me about it. What's happening?
The auras around the earth. Many are focusing on the new earth.
Can you tell me about this new earth?
It's already here.
Is this new earth something that's physical or vibrational?
It's our creation.
Does it look any different than the other earth?
Another dimension.
Another dimension. What dimension is it?
A new one.
It doesn't exist now?
It does.
It does.
It's here now.
Okay. How do we get on this new earth? What's the choice?
Simply create it.
Is this individually or collectively?
Both.
Both. Mm-hmm. So, what would a thought be in the new earth? What would it look like? The type of thought that we would be having individually and collectively?
Mutually beneficial.
Mutually beneficial.
For the well-being of all.
Mm-hmm. Without the ego in the middle of it.
The ego does not reign supreme there.
What does reign supreme there?
Love.
Mm. Would this be the kind of love that you would have for example, nature? Animals?
All mm-hmm. things. It's just we're still in the old earth
mm-hmm.
and all the other earths.
How many other earths are there?
Many.
Mm-hmm. Are these different dimensions?
Infinite.
Infinite. How do you determine which earth you're on?
You learned this. We all have a veil is being lifted.
Mm-hmm.
And you will decide which earth to shift your focus to.
Hmm.
Many will fear many will not notice some will feel as if they are going insane.
Hmm.
And some recognize the new earth for what it is and evolve there.
Is it possible for anyone right now to be on the new earth?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. How do you know if you're on the new earth? Would you recognize it in yourself?
Only if you have been made to see.
Mm. And who decides that?
You.
Mm.
Yourself. All. You need only surrender.
Mm-hmm.
And open your eyes.
and open your eyes. Who's helping us with this evolution?
Many. Many races. Mm-hmm. Many entities.
How are they doing it? How are they helping?
Many are incarnating into lifetimes. Many places, many times.
Mm-hmm. Now, when you're saying many times, are we talking about just the time we're living now or in past and future?
Human concept. Mm.
Can they incarnate into a so-called past life of a person?
Yes. Mm-hmm. They all are happening side by side. Mm-hmm.
Where you are now, are you in the same timeline as the person who is speaking?
I'm in space. Mm-hmm. Of the earth. Mm-hmm.
What association do you have with the man that's speaking?
I am him. Mm-hmm. He is me.
Are you his higher self?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Why did you bring him to the session today?
It is our wish.
What is your wish?
To evolve.
To evolve.
Evolve. Mm-hmm. Mankind.
How can you help in particular?
Love.
Can you tell me more?
It's it is time. Mm-hmm. Mankind must move forward.
How long will it take for mankind to move forward to where it would completely evolve?
It's an infinite process. Mm. It's very slow. Mm. deliberate.
What's happening right now besides the incarnation of the new generation of souls to move this forward, to push the evolution forward?
There is longer count, just as there are the seasons here on Earth. There is a longer count in the universe.
Mm-hmm. Tell me about that.
Man forgets. There is a changing of the seasons on a much greater time scale that man forgets. Mm-hmm. And this changing, lifting of the veil, is upon mankind again. Mm-hmm. And whether man is ready to evolve or not, this evolution of the planet will take place.
So are you saying that it's the planet that's evolving and not mankind?
Both.
Both. Mm-hmm. In years, does this have anything to do with the revolutions of the Earth around celestial beings or planets? Is there like a 25,000 year cycle?
There are many cycles on the long count.
Many cycles on the long count? Mm-hmm.
Just as on Earth, there are many milestones, seasonal, centuries. There are on the long count as well. And you can look in to the earth for confirmation of this many times over the eons, as man and life been forced to evolve. Man forgets.
When we evolve, we don't ask this again. Is there a destruction on the earth?
There is a cleansing. Yes.
Yes. So is this why you say that some will be in fear? You had made mention that, you know, some people are going to be in fear and some people will.
All things that have ever occurred will occur. Every outcome and possibility that has been imagined has occurred and will occur again. The earth is a living being, just as man, each soul.
Just as man needs what?
Each soul.
Each soul.
Is a smaller living, vibrant potential. Just as Earth once was.
Just as Earth was once was. What's going on with Earth now?
It's evolving. The Earth you asked of the long count.
Tell me.
The constellations in your sky are not by accident. They're there
Tell me.
As your guide. The earth, each age has its lesson of evolution, and the age of Aquarius will spill out.
The age of grace?
Aquarius.
Oh, the age of Aquarius. Will spill out?
Yes.
How does that work? What's that age for? What will happen?
It will spill the passing of Pisces. The fish will be spilled out onto the land. It has happened before. It will happen again and again.
So are you saying there will be massive floods? Spilling of the oceans on land?
No.
Tell me.
When the veil is lifted, all perception for what is reality change. Man will perceive what he has been kept shielded from seeing, perceiving. He will be spilled out from his comfortable ocean.
Many have not yet evolved.
Many will be lost. Mm. Many will reside in the false, lap of fear. They will not make sleep.
They will not make it.
They will not evolve.
They will not evolve. So what happens to these people who won't evolve and won't make it?
They are thrown back to the mix.
What does that mean?
They will go into the light.
They will go into the light.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And what happens to the rest that are evolved?
They will be in the new earth.
Mm-hmm. Now, going back to the ones that are going into the light, does that mean that they'll lose their bodies and go back to source?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Will this be in a sudden way, or will it take time?
Many will not even be aware that they have passed.
So they will disappear.
They will be stuck.
They will be stuck?
Mankind cannot help but die into their expectations, unfulfilled expectations. Many will reside in their own creations, their own false realities.
Mm-hmm.
Until they realize that they no longer are with the living.
Now, when we talk about these people that are not evolved, some of them are family members, some of them are friends. What happens when one is awakened and one is not? Many people are concerned that their spouse or their child is not evolved, or their parent.
Each soul is unique. Each soul fits into each plays a part that's integral to the overall. What may seem unevolved may be the most spiritually evolved. What seems as simple-minded may be the highest form of sacrifice and love that a soul can make.
So we can't judge just by seeing someone, how evolved they are.
Unless you are in their shoes, literally.
Unless you're in their shoes. Who chooses? You do not know. Who chooses who goes to the new earth?
We do. We all have made the choice already.
Can you tell if you've made the choice?
Yes.
Can you tell me how you know?
Resonates within. The mere recognition all things in this place crave recognition.
In this place, it craves recognition.
Yes. To be noticed. Loved.
Is that part of the ego?
You know this already. We have all chosen long ago what our part will be.
What will Gary's part be?
Sacrifice.
Sacrifice? What kind of sacrifice? He wants to know what his mission is.
He's doing it now. He knows.
Well, it would be nice for you to tell him, just to get confirmation. Can you tell him what his mission is? In your words.
And still courage. Humans. Everything in this place is infested with fear. Every living cell. Is to push every soul to push them forward.
Is he on the path, or is he still looking for a way?
Like you. Is considered great. There is no higher. Form of love. Oneself for another being.
Oh. Is he sacrificing himself now?
You are also. Mm-hmm. Many are.
Is this helping?
It's necessary.
Go on.
Every living being matters.
Mm-hmm. Every living being matters.
Yes.
We're talking everything. Insects, birds, animals.
Yes.
Rocks.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Man does not know what he does. Man. Earth.
The walking blind.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. We don't see.
If you were aware of all that you do, not just to your own planet, but to the other dimensions.
Tell me what he's feeling. What are you showing him?
He sees himself.
You're giving him a life review?
He is aware. Yes.
Mm-hmm. What did you show him?
weeps.
What else?
No one.
How is this affecting him?
He has prepared already. He weeps as the earth weeps.
He has seen a lot of destruction of trees, of land.
Yes.
How does that affect him?
We all will feel consequences of our lives.
Can you explain how we would feel those consequences?
All things are connected. We are all the same. All are connected to the Creator. You have the power at any moment of your life to feel what he is now.
Why have we chosen to be separate and not feel?
It was a great experiment. How far from source could we thrive?
How is it working, this experiment?
It's evolving.
Is the Creator ever going to stop the experiment and just let us all know what it feels like to be one?
God seeks companions. Not followers. The Creator eyes. It is in each of us to look within at any time of your choosing. You need only seek the Creator. Look within.
How do we use the powers of the Creator when we don't know how?
Process. It's not by accident. You need only the desire to know the Creator. It's meant to be a struggle.
It's meant to be a struggle?
Struggle makes all things stronger. Earth, your life, all life, is based on experience. Cannot move forward without this struggle.
Why do people have more struggle than others?
Fear. Ego.
How do we minimize the struggle?
Let go of fear.
Let go of fear?
Yes.
But doesn't fear have its moments when it's necessary that keeps us out of danger? Or is that something different?
That there is nothing to fear, even in the face of danger. Fear holds you back. There is no death as you perceive it to be.
What does happen to us when we lose our body?
You make an amazing discovery.
What's that?
Your soul survives. You will fall into your expectations when you pass some who whose beliefs are of nothingness will mean nothingness. Most will seek out the light.
What happens to those that don't go to the light? I find a lot of them attached to people.
They are addicted to the physical plane. They have unrealized many attach themselves to people, the living or objects they coveted.
So we could actually purchase an item that has somebody attached to it? And bring it home.
In some instances, yes. There are many who seek these beings out. This never-ending task.
I spend a lot of my sessions sending these to the light.
Many create unneeded attachments with other souls. Or desires. Earth is full of addictions. And many many souls fall into these same soul traps after their earthly existence. You see, there is just as much struggle where I am now.
Why is that? Being a higher self. Why is there struggle?
As stated, we all seek to evolve. Struggle makes us stronger. And we all thrive on experience.
Even in the non-physical plane?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Is that why sometimes when I speak with someone's higher self, it seems a lot more evolved than others?
Yes. Mm-hmm. There are many who seek to manipulate and control here also.
Can you tell me about that? It seems something important.
Yes. This body is
Does he need a rest?
There are those who because of unfulfilled desires, unlived, unrealized the earth plane, there are evolved entities that will prey upon those fixated with the physical.
So those who are greedy or maybe addicted to things?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Those, they fall prey to them?
There are many soul traps. Mm-hmm. And they will use their energy for yes. The most important thing one can do is to prepare for death.
To prepare for death. Many people are afraid of death, though. How can we prepare for it?
Meditate. You must learn to create your own radiant being. The stronger the spin, the vibrational spin.
The vibrational spin?
Yes.
Is Gary having any ill feelings?
It is matching his vibrational frequency.
So what's going on with his body? Is he feeling ill?
No. It is tuning.
Okay. Could you help adjust with that?
I have been.
Okay, good.
This experience is a new sensation.
Gary had talked about wanting to know more about the new earth, and you've given us a lot of information today. Is this something that we should be doing in the future together again?
Yes. Everyone should prepare when the veil is lifted.
What's the best way to prepare? Meditate? Okay. What's the best way to meditate? There are many people who just cannot still their mind.
They must learn to still their minds. They must learn to look within and imagine their radiant being. For when this passing comes, many will not be able many will be lost.
So it's very important to meditate.
Yes. Learn to create your radiant being. Many, upon passing, will not even realize the environment, the laws, that make up the other side.
The laws that make up the other side, the non-physical side. Very different to this one.
Yes.
Good.
They will be as if newborn babies that cannot speak or even crawl.
In the non-physical.
Yes.
Sense. Brand new.
Yes.
To all of the information. Who helps these newborn spirits in this non-physical realm? Who helps? Who teaches them the laws?
There are those who will sacrifice themselves to help. But the goal is to evolve now.
Very good. Thank you. Are you able to answer Gary's personal questions now?
He knows the answers.
So we don't need to ask any of these questions? Or would you like, or is he tired now and you'd like to answer these at a different time?
He knows the answers.
Very good. Thank you so much. Do you have a message for me today?
You are important. Your mission is the mission of all to evolve. Your time is short. Prepare.
Start meditating.
Yes. It is the most important thing that one can do. You must remove the fear of ridicule. That is all.
Wonderful. Thank you very much. What message do you have to give Gary today, who came all this distance?
Courage.
He is a warrior.
You all are warriors. No one in this place are not.
What are you showing, Gary?
The new earth. His body.
What about his body? What are you showing him?
How it can radiate. Just by the thoughts.
Beautiful.
And his mind.
And that's how it'll be on the new earth?
Yes.
Wonderful. If Gary and I were to get together again to do this, would you be willing to give more information about the new earth?
He must prepare his physical self.
Mm-hmm. Can you tell him how?
He has been given the message. Mm-hmm. He must meditate
. Is this something that he came here to do, or that we both came here to do?
Yes. Mm-hmm. There are many now as you, and all will continue. It has been passed on to you.
Who has passed it on to me?
You were chosen, and you accepted.
Is this before I was born or afterwards?
Yes.
Before?
Yes. Many. Not all succeed. Many fall prey to the distractions of addiction in this place.
So I need to keep myself focused and not be distracted.
Always.
Mm-hmm. Good. Thank you very much.
That is all.
Thank you very much for all of the information you've given Gary today, and me, and anybody else who sees this. I know he's really going to appreciate it. Welcome back. How do you feel?
My whole body is tingling.
Is it a good tingling?
It's almost too much. So sad.
You saw?
Yeah.
Tell me what you saw. You were given a lot of information, a lot of visuals.
How could that be real?
How long do you think you were under?
I don't know.
How did it feel? Fast? Long?
Short.
Sure?
Just what everybody else says, short. Maybe 20 minutes.
Yeah. Try an hour and 45 minutes.
You know, and you start, it's just what you said. I just felt like I was just talking and then suddenly grabs you.
Mm-hmm. For someone who's always in control, I think you did a great job. I think we found the person who's going to work with me.
I can't remember the last time I cried. You did it twice in one day. That's... Thank you, Alba.
You're welcome. Is this something you're going to share?
Oh, man. I don't care. I'm not afraid.
We could talk about it. It was very deep.
Other person is strong.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, man.
Your higher self is strong.
It's really intense. It's almost, you can't. Oh, God. When I had my out-of-body experience, what brought me back? I felt, as I was looking at all the edges, of the, looking at all the cells, I felt this huge presence behind me. It was so bright. And I felt like a little tiny, insignificant, little dim, nothing. And I cowered. And just that little bit of hesitation made me want to run and hide and get back to my body. I thought I had died. It wasn't easy to will myself back. And I remember it was hard to try to anchor my body back in, but that feeling of that bright, I was afraid to even look. So immense. That's what it was just now. It's still, my body is vibrating. It's... I can't believe that's me.
Life changing? Was it worth doing this? Now that you've seen it from the other side?
Yes. Have you?
I didn't have the same experience as you did, but yours was mind-blowing.
It didn't feel mind-blowing. It felt like, for me, it was a review. It was...
You had like a life review there for a little while, right?
It was get off your ass. That's what it was. Oh, man. Yeah. I don't want to go through that again.
You don't?
No, I felt like I was being chastised. My hand slapped on the wrist.
This is the review that you're talking about.
Yeah.
Yeah. I guess you needed that to move forward, to complete your mission.
It's different for me, Alba. You're lucky. I'm lucky too. Maybe you're a little bit stronger than me in certain things. You don't remember, that's it.
That's it.
Yeah.
The recycle bin. It helps. It was a gift.
You're amazing. You really are.
How's your body feel now?
I feel like I just had the flu and I just woke up in the middle of the night and it's gone, and I feel like I've just been sweating, and I feel like I'm not a sweater, but my hands are like completely, I'm like, I have the cold sweats now because I never get wet palms or anything. If anything, I'm like Mr. Dry.
How'd the selenite work? I guess so.
I don't know. It's just...
Did they vibrate or anything for you? You feel anything?
I just remember seeing those images again.
You're going to be seeing that for the next few days because you're wide open now.
I think so.
Yep.
Wow. Wow. Like the little cells that make up everything. Auras. Vibrating auras. You could see another kind of ring from people and all their thoughts. All of it going on. Just...
You had a great experience. I don't think you expected that, did you? Not to that extent, anyway.
He had mercy on me.
Yeah. It could have been worse.
It's not fun not being in control.
Yeah. You gotta give up the reins sometimes.
When I have to say something, it's like, oh my God.
Good. We set. You want to say goodbye?
Yeah.
We're going to share this?
Oh my God. Can I watch it first?
Of course you can.
Oh man. I don't even remember any of it. I only remember just what it looked like. Oh God. Did I say anything crazy?
No.
Honest.
Not at all. It was all about talk about New Earth.
Any family or anything?
Nope. Not at all. It was all about the New Earth. Everything is about the Earth. It was wonderful. It was all about the New Earth. All of it.
I just remember sweating. Just... God, it's like burned. It's like it just felt too good. It's like when you... Like a little child and you look at someone and... You just... You feel so good you have to look away. It's like that.
Wow. That's great.
Yeah.
So whenever you're ready.
I'm ready.
All right. So we just had an amazing session.
It was amazing.
Amazing.
It was amazing.
You had no idea that this was going to happen this way?
No. Like you, I probably have watched quite a few of Alba's videos and I just could not help but bring myself to come experience this in person.
And you are coming from?
I came all the way from San Diego. Really, it's not that big of a trip to get out here. Mm-hmm. And it's cheap to stay here. It was really inexpensive for me. And but I kind of thought it was going to be like a lot of the other experiences that I saw on your tape. But man, it was... Yeah, you said it. It was life-changing. So,
Tell me what happened with this life review, because there were times where you just stopped and you were seeing something, and it was almost startling to watch the way you were reacting. What were you seeing?
Some of it, it felt I was being shown images that I saw what the earth is going to go through. Mm-hmm. I saw how we're damaging the earth mm-hmm. every single day. I saw the negligence and the intentional looking away, mm-hmm. you know, in the name of greed. Mm-hmm. It hurt. I could feel everything that I was seeing on I know this sounds crazy, a cellular level. It's as if I was in the shoes of everything that was being destroyed, and I can feel it and experience it. And it was too much to endure. Mm-hmm. Emotionally, I couldn't handle it. And mm-hmm. and I wasn't really, I felt as though it's really hard to explain it. It was as if I was in two places at once, almost three places, because this other person is talking. And I'm kind of in the background mm-hmm. listening.
Yeah.
And then he throws him, me. Then I've thrown these images inside of my head. And you're experiencing that at the same time. And I can hear you asking the questions. Mm-hmm. I don't remember all of it. Mm-hmm. I remember certain things that have a lot of emotion tied to it. Mm-hmm. But I'm saying, answer. I'm trying to answer, but I can't. But I realize, because I can feel from all perspectives.
Yeah.
First, second, and third person, it's really strange. I can tell that because of me, mm-hmm. the way I am, mm-hmm. and whatever the limitations of my body has, he's just sitting there like, how the fuck do I use? I'm sorry. How do I use the words, the vocabulary that's mm-hmm. in this little man's head? Mm-hmm. To express. My body as it is was a limitation, and then also the words that he was trying to choose to my intellect.
Now there was a lot of noise. How did the noise affect you?
I didn't hear anything.
Because there's palm fronds banging up on the window. There's
I don't remember any of that.
And this is something I bring up because you are in an industry where you pick up all of this stuff. And you tell me you can hear me gulp when I'm drinking water on this, when you're watching my videos. You can hear me rustling papers. And how is it feeling for you being in that position? How does that affect you?
I didn't notice anything. It was as if... to be honest, I don't hardly remember any of it. It's the damnedest thing. I only remember mm-hmm. the things that had really strong images where I felt like I cried like a baby for like an hour. I just could not stop crying. And that's what I remember most. Yeah. I don't remember the small talk that much. It just felt like it was a constant struggle. The whole thing to try to
express it, like with the vocabulary or what?
No, it wasn't me. I felt like I was in the background again, and I was just trying to. I wanted to stop crying. That's what I was trying to do. It was a constant struggle to try to stop crying, and I couldn't stop. Mm-hmm. That's what it was.
You did great.
I wasn't worrying about the camera. I forgot about all that stuff. I was just trying to stop crying. I didn't want to feel that mm-hmm. that emotion anymore.
Yeah.
Not for you or anybody else. It was just for me. It was weird. Yeah.
So you recommend it for other people?
I think rather than just say I recommend, you should come out because it's in Miami.
And the temperature.
And Alba's amazing, by the way. She really is. It's really easy to connect because she feels like you've known her for a long time.
You know, one thing that you said when we were interviewing is that now I know why it's 4 hours. And we've actually spent more. We've actually spent, holy moly.
Alba and I had a chance to connect. She really takes an adequate, I don't want to say adequate. She really takes the time to get to know you and find out
information that she needs to help make you understand what's going to take place during the session. She does a really good job of relaxing you and making you feel comfortable. I think the whole thing is to make sure that the person that's going to go through this experience knows what's coming and that they feel comfortable, because a lot of people like me, you're in control of how you appear to everybody when you're out walking around every day. Mm-hmm. What I was going to say is, I think that if just my own personal experience, if everybody had an experience like this, where they either actually get in touch with their higher self, or they have some sort of communication with the other side in any way, shape, or form, it is a life-changing event, to use your words. It is. And you will change how you view reality and life and how you communicate and interact with people every day. It changes you for the better. So that's why you should come out and do it. I think if more people did this, if every single person did this,
The world would be different.
It would be.
So the world would be totally different. You'd see things from a different perspective.
That's why you should come. Not because I recommend it. You should come to have a positive impact on the world. That's just me, though.
Thank you very much. So
welcome. You rock, Alba.
Thank you. So if you want to have a session with me, you know where to go, albaweinman.com. Very easy to find my calendar, and you just book it and have a session.
Okay, sweet. But that was just a practice, right?
No, it's not. Give me a hug. We're done. Ah.